So, good afternoon. My name is Ulf Schiemann, and I'm from Germany, from Munich to be precise, in a lovely region north of the Alps. And that's where Metaio is located, one of the forward pioneers of augmented reality.
네, 독일에서 오신 메타이오 회사의 울프 시버이시고요. 오신 지역은 뮌히시고 독일의 북쪽의 알프스 쪽에 위치하는 곳에 있답니다. 이제 거기에서 AR을 많이 연구를 하고 개발하는 회사에서 오셨습니다.
I will try to speak slowly and I hope you understand my English, but in case I have your lovely colleague here who will translate. I noticed the logo of your university. It has an ancient Latin inscription. I don't know if you noticed. It's called Pro Hominum Beneficio, which means for the benefit of mankind. So I like that slogan. I hope that everything we do and also everything you will do in future will be for the benefit of mankind. Metaio has been doing augmented reality for 10 years. As I mentioned, we're one of the pioneers in this field, and augmented reality is a very new technology. Companies oftentimes don't make money yet with it. Many are venture capital finance. We are probably one of the few companies who are actually very profitable at making money with this technology.
네, 메타이오는 이제 그런 신기술, AR이 신기술이기 때문에 그런 것에 접근하는 회사이고요. 10년 동안 연구를 해왔고 신기술이기 때문에 아직까지는 적은 이런 방향으로 개발하는 회사가 적다고 해요. 그래서 또 이제 신기술이기 때문에 그런 적은 회사들이기 때문에 좀 벌어들이는 돈도 많고 그렇게 좀 많은 관심을 받고 있는 회사라고 합니다.
As I mentioned, we're located in Munich, but we also have offices in San Francisco in the United States. We have about 70 employees, full-time employees, we earn our revenue with doing projects for business customers. You can see some of the names here. There are a lot of automotive companies, Lego, Siemens, sort of big name companies that we do augmented reality projects for. I will show some of that stuff in a minute. We have about 450 customers, and as you can see here, today there's about 3 million people worldwide using augmented reality, which has been designed with our technology.
네, 사무실 위치는 뮌히시와 샌프란시스코에 있고요. 70명의 직원과 500개 프로젝트가 진행되고 있습니다. 주로 비즈니스 고객들은 레고와 아래 로고 보이시는 큰 회사들을 고객으로 맞이하고 있고요. 2011년 1월 기준으로 450명의 고객들이 있다고 합니다. 그리고 현재 이용되고 있는 AR 테크놀로지의 그 소비자층은 300만 명이라고 합니다.
Okay, there's not much to say. This is just simply that we have many patents, both in Europe as well as the United States and other countries in the world. You all, you know, from the previous presentation, I assume you know what augmented reality is. I have here my own definition. It's we say it's a seamless and dynamic integration of graphics and other multimedia content with the live camera view, either on a PC or on a mobile device.
네, 그 전에 세미나에서도 들으신 바와 같이 AR의 정의에 관한 간략한 설명을 해주셨는데요. AR은 라이브 카메라 뷰가 탑재된 PC나 모바일 기기를 이용해서 실사 멀티미디어 그래픽의 매끄러운 합성을 뜻합니다.
Many people that busy themselves with augmented reality, it's still very experimental, and it's also been a little bit in the fun area, the games area, but in reality, there is a huge potential in all kinds of commercial markets, in manufacturing, in commerce, in education, entertainment, social networking, advertising, and many other fields. In fact, this is why Metaio is making money, particularly in the manufacturing era. There are two examples here. One is Lego. There's a customer. Children, they have all over the place, they have toy shops. And the children, they can take a Lego box and they go up to this computer kiosk with a camera, and the computer recognizes the box, and then it will display what's inside. I'll show you that in the video in a minute. And on the right hand side, you can see an engineering application. This is a braking system on a car, and it shows how the component is installed.
네, 이제 그런 합성과 그래픽과 실사의 합성에서는 주로 이제 게임 쪽이나 그런 엔터테이닝 쪽에서 많이 이용되고 있는데요. 메타이오는 이도 좋은 점으로 보고 있지만 거기를 넘어서서 좀 더 큰 가능성에 염두를 두고 있다고 해요. 그런 이유에서 메타이오가 많은 수익을 버는 이유이기도 하는데요. 그 아까 말씀드렸다시피 제조업이나 무역, 마케팅, 교육, 엔터테인먼트나 소셜 네트워크 등등에도 이용을 하고 적용을 시키려고 하고 있습니다. 특히나 그런 매뉴팩처링 쪽에서 많게 그런 활용을 하려고 하고 있고요. 방금 설명드리신 바와 같이 레고 시장에 가서 레고를 화면에 띄워놨을 때 그 위에 이제 그 레고가 다 만들어진 상태가 3D로 보인다든지 하는 그런 방식의 실용성을 강조하고 있고요. 또 그거 외에도 방금 엔지니어링 사진에서 보여드린 바와 같이 프로토타이핑에서 어떤 부품들이 배치될 것인지 3D의 그래픽적인 이미지가 입히지는 것을 보실 수 있습니다.
This is just a brief video. How do I make this big? Shows you some applications. Here, this is a game. You have a marker. This was mentioned in the previous presentation as well. The camera recognizes the marker, and then with the marker, moving the marker, it serves as a game controller, so you can play the game. This is the Lego application. As you can see here in a toy shop, you pick up the box and it shows in 3D what's inside. By turning it, you can see, look at the model from all sides. The same thing here on a smartphone, mobile device. Then we have print ads can be used. We have image recognition and that can display certain things. Here we have another game. It recognizes the marker, and this is used to control a surfer here. Marks and Spencers is a customer in the UK. They're a big chain of department stores, and they sell these greeting cards. They are particularly popular with kids, and you hold them up to the computer and it animates the card. Here we've done this for Marks and JCPenney in the United States. With their catalog of clothing, you can try on different pieces of clothing. This is a similar application for furniture manufacturer in Switzerland, where you could pick out different furniture items and then place them in your own living room and see how it looks. Print media as well, by recognizing the picture, we can then launch, like a little video in the first case. In the second case here, we augment these pictures with comments from this young lady who is a famous singer in Germany. This is projecting a car park in an empty meadow. And this is a solution of crossword puzzles for lazy people who don't want to think. They can look at the answers here. This is indoor navigation. Let me just stop this very briefly to explain. GPS doesn't work inside buildings. So what we do is we use a marker in this trade fair to orientate these, the smartphone, and then from there on it can be used as a guide to find your way around the trade fair. So I can show you where the next presentation happens or whatever. This is a augmented reality game. It's a shooter game. You can do it in your living room. These were just some fun examples. So let me get back to the presentation. Now to the serious stuff. As I said, we actually do projects for B2B customers. And here you can see some applications in factory planning, for example. On the left-hand side, there is a new assembly line being projected. So we can look at the camera, look at the actual hall where this happens, and then project on top of that the new equipment and how well it will fit. So the trick here with augmented reality is it's not difficult to project a graphic image on top of a screen. The trick is, of course, that it has to be in perspective and fit right into the right place where it's supposed to be. If the camera goes nearer or further away, then the graphics have to adjust accordingly and stay in the right place. In the middle, you see a car. This is the car is a graphic, it's augmented reality. The rest is actually the location itself, and you can check exactly whether the new car model will fit there. And on the right-hand side is some kind of construction site being projected.
네, 이제 여기서 AR이 실제 그런 manufacturing 현장에서 어떻게 적용되는지를 보여주고 있는데요. 가장 왼쪽 사진에서 보신 바와 같이 그런 어떤 생산 환경의 계획 레이아웃을 직접 카메라로 그냥 카메라를 위치해서 보았을 때 그런 앵글과 Z축에 모두 맞춰서 반응해서 그래픽이 입혀진다고 합니다. 그런 식으로 계획 레이아웃을 하고요. 가운데에서 자동차도 마찬가지의 경우로 자동차 크기가 얼만큼 해서 이만큼 들어갈 수 있는지를 카메라로 인해서 이제 그거 3D가 입혀지고 그런 분에 대해서 이제 그러한 계획을 짤 수가 있고요. 가장 오른쪽 같은 경우에도 어떤 건설 장소에서 치수 기입을 하기 훨씬 수월하게 도와주고 있습니다.
Yeah, so these, for example, we have a lot of customers in the automobile industry, also Toyota, but many of the German companies, Volkswagen, BMW, and they use it for all sorts of things. And so it's become quite popular in that field. Here you can see some of this car manufacturing. The picture on the left you saw already, this is a braking system. Then in the middle, there are different components, and they displays here where they fit exactly. It can be used for maintenance or for explanation on how to fit particular components inside an engine or inside a car, that kind of stuff.
그 전에도 보여드린 사진과 같은 사진인데요. 이런 바와 같이 그런 자동차 내부에 들어가는 부품들이나 추가 장치들이 어떻게 들어갈 것인지를 시뮬레이션 해볼 수 있고 브레이크 장치의 뭐 설치 프로세스 같은 것도 함께 시뮬레이션 해볼 수 있습니다. 그래서 아까 좀 일찍 말씀하셨는데 그런 BMW나 폴크스바겐 같은 곳에서도 많이 활용을 하고 있다고 합니다.
Here is another application like this is for maintenance, for example, service on cars. On the left is, I think, the how to mount or dismount the radiator. It could tell you which screws to unscrew. In the middle, similar thing. The guy is actually wearing one of these headsets where you can look through and see the augmented reality look through the headset. The problem with these headsets is they are still very heavy and kind of uncomfortable to wear, but we are sure that with time they will become light and easy, so you may in future have people walking around the city wearing glasses and actually getting a heads-up display on what's going on in the city.
대해서 위에 보시는 바와 같이 사진에서도 워크플로우의 단계적인 디스플레이를 보여줄 수도 있고요. 그런 매뉴얼의 디지털 애니메이팅도 가능하고 이제 실제 사진에서 보시면 안경 같은 거 위에 쓰고 있는데 이제 그러한 안경을 통해서 이런 디스플레이나 부품 체크를 할 수 있습니다. 근데 아직까지는 안경이 되게 무겁고 가격이 굉장히 센데 이제 이런 것을 계속 아직도 개발 중이고 보완 중이기 때문에 가까운 미래에 가볍게 개발해서 정말 이제 그냥 거실에서도 이 안경을 쓰고 활용할 수 있도록 개발 중이라고 합니다.
And of course, it can be used also in commercial applications. On the left, we see a sort of kiosk. This is similar to what you've just seen in the film with Lego, where in the Lego shops, you have these kiosks. There are computers behind it and a camera. And by holding up a picture or a marker, it can be recognized. In the Lego case, it's the box. The box itself is being recognized. And then some kind of display is being generated. In the middle, this is a print media where a picture may be recognized or some kind of code, and then again it projects in this case here, a 3D image of these windmills. This is something we did for this magazine Popular Science in the United States, and that was a very successful campaign. On the right-hand side is augmented reality now on mobile devices, and that's where a lot of the future of augmented reality will be, because that is the possibility for people like yourselves, the normal consumers, walking around carrying their smartphones or their tablets and enjoying the benefits of augmented reality presentations.
방금 이제 영상에서도 보셨는데요. 이러한 증강현실 매점이나 그런 키오스크 개념인데 이런 것이 레고 같은 경우에도 세워져 있어서 레고를 만약에 비춘다면 그에 관련된 인포메이션이 뜬다거나 3D 디스플레이를 보여주는 것이고요. 또 집에서 이런 잡지 같은 것을 PC나 모바일에 비췄을 때 그 잡지에 관한 내용이 3D 애니메이션으로 뜬다든지 하는 경우입니다. 실제로 미국에 있는 퍼퓰러 사이언스에서 이를 활용했고요. 또 이제 모바일 같은 경우에는 가장 많이 미래의 증강 현실이 가장 많이 활용될 수 있는 케이스인데요. 많은 사람들이 스마트폰을 직접 이제 들고 다니고 모바일이기 때문에 가장 활용도가 높고 쉽게 접근을 할 수 있다고 합니다.
Okay, basically this is what we do. We on the left-hand side, we do a lot of research into this kind of technology. We do research on our own. We also do research together with the Technical University in Munich. They often have funded projects, and so we participate in research projects or do them entirely on our own, but for the benefit of the university there. From this work, we created a set of tools, which you see as the next one here, Unify. These tools are basically a set of libraries in C++ which we sell. So professional organizations, maybe designers or advertising agencies, they can buy these tools and build their own AR experiences with that. Now, the mobile product is a Junaio, we call it Junaio. That is a free of charge application which you can download from the App Store if you have an Apple iPhone or the Android marketplace, and it doesn't cost anything. Anybody can download it. Now this is for consumers, and we are filling this with content. Every day we add new information channels into this Junaio. We have now close to 500, I believe. And we have certified developers, which you see here in the middle. They provide the content. There is about 4,000 developers now internationally that work with Junaio, and they build AR experiences in their own channels. The previous speaker here mentioned about the difficulty maybe of doing AR. Here, it's actually quite easy, because when you go to our website, anybody can register as a developer, and there are tutorials there that explain how to do it using our software. And if you do a good job and we approve of the things that you do, you can become actually a certified developer and also earn money with it. So this is our business model with Junaio.
네, 메타이오 특히 준하이어의 그런 어떤 작업 과정인데요. 테크놀로지 같은 경우에는 뮤니히에 있는 공대와 함께 공동 작업을 하기도 하고요. 툴 같은 경우에는 이제 유니파이에서 개발됐는데 실제로 판매되는 툴이기도 합니다. 그래서 다른 회사에서 그것을 구매를 해서 이용하는 경우가 많고요. 그 이제 모바일 쪽에서 이제 프리 앱으로 준하이오라고 불리는데 이제 애플 스토어에 가시면 다운받으실 수 있어요. 아이패드나 아이폰 있으신 분들은 다운받으실 수 있고요. 매번 새로운 정보 채널이 업데이트되고 있고, 그리고 컨텐츠 같은 경우에도 아래 로고 보시듯이 아래와 같은 회사에서 4,000명의 개발자가 참여를 하고 있습니다. 그래서 매번 새롭게 개발되고 업데이트가 되고 있고요. 또 그런 AR에 그 접근하기 힘든 그런 기술적인 면을 언급을 하셨는데요. 실제로 웹사이트 들어가 보면은 그런 매번 그 개발자를 계속 취업으로 받고 있고요. 또한 이런 방금 언급을 하신 툴에 관한 튜토리얼도 제공을 하고 있다고 합니다.
Wonderful. Okay, so augmented reality really is we have reality on one side and we have digital information on the other side called like virtual reality. In fact, that's how Metaio started. One of our founders is Peter Meyer, who is the chief technical officer. He got very early on involved with virtual reality, and then that led to merging the two, therefore augmented reality. Now, it's a very new technology, but it's been quite a while. Amazingly, it took quite a while to get where we are today. So one of the applications here, or one of the technologies that are important, is touchscreen. On the left here is a well-known person, Nicholas Negroponte. In 1984, he gave a speech. If you look at our presentation, you can actually look up the speech on the internet. And he was talking about first experiences with touchscreens and the difficulties involved. Then we had this other compact mobile device where you use the stylus. It wasn't actually a touchscreen, but it was a first sort of implementation of that. Shut up. He doesn't give up. Anyway, so today, with the smartphones that we have today, we have perfected now the touchscreen technology, which is one of the key things that we use in AR, particularly mobile AR. Good. On the graphic side, same thing. It took almost the same amount of time from first fundamentals of digital image processing here. I believe this is a standard work by this researcher here. And then in 1993, they had the idea of using augmented reality for practical purposes. And this was taking some piece of equipment like a printer and showing how to change a cartridge or do some maintenance on it. So, we have now this old example. This has been around a while, very complicated, as you can see, with complicated equipment, etc. We now do this on the smartphone, very easy. And because this is a nice example, I will show you how this works in this little film. So here we have a Samsung printer, and just to use something that you could have at home. And use a smartphone. Now, this could be done with Jhonaya, for example. And we look at the printer, and it recognizes it by its shape. It analyzes the corners of that object and recognizes it. Now it tells the user graphically how to change the cartridge here, for example. Okay, so as you can see, there is a perfect merge of the graphic overlays and the actual machine itself. And this is how it recognizes. There are many different points in space and three-dimensional space, and that is compared against an image database in order to recognize this kind of printer model. Now, you can very well imagine that this kind of thing could be done for all sorts of equipment. It could be for a television, how you hook up your television or your modem or whatever. So for manufacturers, it would reduce cost because rather than printing these instruction manuals in 38 different languages, you know, that's kind of expensive. And this would be a very easy option to just use with a smartphone. So we can see lots of those things coming up in the future. So really what we're doing is we're merging the real world with the digital world. You know, before we had this gap, you know, you could work on a computer, but there was no communication between a computer and the real world. Then, as you can see there on the right, there is no input-output from the computer fields. You can work with many different computers doing different things, maybe at the same time, but you're still not communicating with the real world. So what we're doing here with augmented reality is we're merging the two worlds to become one.
네, 여기에서 이제 그런 증강현실의 장점에 대해서 설명드릴 수 있는데요. 일반 GUI 같은 경우에는 컴퓨터와의 상호작용도 일어나고 그런 실제 세계와의 상호작용도 일어나는데 그 두 사이에는 큰 갭이 있습니다. 또 비의 가상현실 같은 경우에는 실제 세계와의 커뮤니케이션 되지 않고 오직 컴퓨터의 커뮤니케이션이 가능합니다. 그러나 이번에 이제 증강현실 같은 경우에는 그 두 가지 그런 가상과 현실이라는 것이 결합이 되어 있기 때문에 동시에 계속 상호작용이 가능하다는 장점이 있습니다.
Well, I mentioned mobile devices. Now we're experiencing this explosion of smartphones in the world. Gartner Inc., they are IT researchers, market researchers, very well known. They project 1.3 billion smartphone devices around the world. That's an incredible number. Now it changes our lifestyle, and people rely more and more on these little devices. And you're on the go, you're in the city, you're sitting in a cafe, and you're accessing information with these very smart little machines. Now, also for marketers, companies, brands that want to market something, it changes the game. They have to become as mobile as their customers. And using these devices is different from sitting at your PC at home. You don't have a keyboard, you don't have a mouse, you just have a tiny screen which it's not very easy to look up websites, you know, with this tiny screen. You don't want to type, so we need another type of human machine interface with that. And AR is very well positioned to help us there.
네, 지금 계속해서 스마트폰 유저들이 늘고 있는데요. 가트너 잉크 같은 경우에도 2013년도에는 130억 명의 스마트폰 유저로 폭발적인 증가를 이룰 것으로 생각하고 있습니다. 그래서 이와 보시는 바와 같이 많은 사람들이 이제 점점 더 이런 작은 기기들에 의존을 하게 되는데요. 실제로 이제 이런 새로운 필드가 생겼기 때문에 경영자들 또한 그 소비자들과 같이 그런 스마트폰의 대세를 따라서 유동적으로 행동할 필요가 있다고 생각을 하십니다. 그렇기 때문에 이런 모바일 세상에 갔을 때 이제 좀 더 인포메이션에 대한 쉬운 접근이 필요하고 작은 스크린에 맞는 인터페이스를 구축해야 하며 또한 그런 센서를 활용하는 것이 중요하다고 생각됩니다.
So that's why AR has become a buzzword. Everybody talks about AR. If you look at the internet and you search in Google with topics like AR, you get 700,000, 800,000 hits. It's being very much talked about, written about in blogs, etc. But most of that is just projections. None of that in the last year, you know, was actually real. So the idea was something like you see here, you know, where you take a camera and look at people and then it gives you information on this person, etc. So, you know, we don't have that really. The other one is here where you look at a city and it recognizes the building and maybe even the floor, which company's on which floor, etc. So, yes, that's something that we're getting to. So this year now, with something like Jonayo on a mobile phone or on a tablet, we're getting very close to this idea. It makes input becomes easier here because on a smartphone we have a number of sensors that give us input. One of them is GPS, so it tells us where this smartphone actually physically is, you know, where the user happens to be. Then we have a compass inside, so if we, as we look around with the camera, the software knows where we're looking at. The other thing is that with this technology that Metaio provides, we can do image recognition. So we don't have to type very much. We can point the camera at something and we can recognize it. It could be a product, it could be a poster. For example, we look at a movie poster, it recognizes the movie and it shows us the trailer as a video display. So this is the kind of multimedia content that we can now display. There's no limit really. We can do text, image, video, we can show maps, AR overlay, we can throw 3D models, etc. The interesting thing here, it's not only image recognition, but we also want to glue the digital content onto the image. So for example, if you look at the movie poster that I explained, it represents a frame in the camera. So I can actually play the movie exactly in that frame. Or I can generate a 3D model and then have that exactly glued to the particular object and enhancing that object. Like you saw on the factory floor where we place something exactly in perspective on the right spot, we can do this here as well with a movie or with a 3D moving model.
Yeah, 2010년도에서부터 증강현실에 대한 관심이 되게 많았었고 아이디어도 굉장히 많이 쏟아져 나왔다고 해요. 그래서 이 전에 보여주신 두 그림 같은 경우에 그런 아이디어를 한번 그런 2D 화면에 한번 해본 경우인데요. 실제적으로 기술은 그러나 발전이 되지 않았기 때문에 아이디어만 계속 나오고 실제로 이용이 되지는 못하고 있었는데요. 그러나 이제는 준하이어 같은 경우에서도 보는 바와 같이 이러한 게 기술적으로 해결이 많이 되어서 실제로도 많이 활용을 할 수 있다고 해요. 이제 그러므로 이제 스마트폰을 활용을 해서 그런 그 카메라 기능을 이용해서 좀 더 그런 정보에 대한 접근이 용이해지도록 했고요. 위치를 인식한다거나 시각적으로 그런 제품이나 포스터를 인식을 해서 뭐 영화 포스터에다가 카메라를 댄다면 그 예고편이 재생이 된다거나 하는 그런 어떤 전에 있었던 제약이나 제한들이 많이 없어졌어요. 그래서 그러므로 인해서 이제 실질적으로 그 작년만 해도 아이디어만 나왔던 것들이 이제 실제로 이제 가능하게 되었고요. 이제 뭐 3D 모델 같은 게 특정 아까 그런 영상에서 보신 바와 같이 그런 3D에 실재하는 공간에 3D 의자를 배치를 해서 어떤 위치도 조정할 수 있고 크기도 조정할 수 있도록 그렇게 많은 것이 시도되고 있습니다.
Here are some practical examples. Now, as I mentioned, Jonayo can be downloaded for free. Anybody can see this, what I'm showing here. As I said, we have close to 500 different information channels. These are just a few examples. On the left, you see this is in San Francisco public transport. So you can see when is the next train leaving, at what time, and what platform. Then the next one on the right is free office space. You can walk around the city and say, you know, where is office space available for rent? And you're holding up and you'd see it right on the building and click on it, then you get phone numbers and information. The next one is eBay. Probably everybody knows eBay. They're very big in the United States and in Europe for buying secondhand things. So they have a classified section. Classified means these are small ads in a newspaper, so except here they're not in the newspaper. We have them on Jonayo, so you can look around where you are and say within the radius of 5 miles or 10 miles from where you are, what is on offer. And you can select it by keyword. You can say, I want to buy a bicycle, and it shows you everybody who offers a bicycle in your close neighborhood. Can I translate it already?
Okay. 첫 번째 사진은 이제 그런 대중교통 같은 경우에서 기차가 언제 출발하는지 그런 정보를 그런 대중교통 기차역 같은 데 핸드폰을 갖다 대면 그에 관련된 정보가 뜹니다. 또 두 번째 사진 같은 경우에는 건물에서 핸드폰을 갖다가 이제 카메라로 보았을 때 만약에 이제 사무실 렌트를 하고 싶다 할 때 비어있는 사무실 같은 정보를 보여주고요. 또 세 번째 사진 같은 경우에는 그런 중고 관련된 그런 만약에 제가 중고 자전거를 사고 싶다고 했을 때 그런 키워드 검색을 하면은 이 지역에 사는 사람들에서 중고 자전거를 팔고 싶은 사람들의 정보가 뜨는 경우로 이제 활용이 되고 있습니다.
These first three examples is what we call location based. So really we look at the location of the user and we give him information. Now as far as AR is concerned, this is not too complicated because you can see there are just some little text images superimposed on reality. The next samples are more demanding AR solutions, and they are more on the level of what we call image sensitive, because as you can see on the Lego example, we recognize the box or the image on the box and then display a 3D model based on that information. The next example there is you can pick out a t-shirt from a catalog and try it on yourself and see how it looks. This can be either done by taking a photo of yourself, or now you have, with tablets it's possible, you have cameras in both directions so you can take a picture of yourself and then actually adjust the t-shirt and see how it fits you. The next one is very interesting as well. This is media. There are lots of applications for print media. In this example here, we have a famous TV personality on the cover of this magazine. We recognize her and then we display her actually taking the fingers away from the hands away from her face, and smiling, and everybody sees who it actually is. So print media is great for advertising as well. So we can recognize an ad and provide enhanced digital information in combination with the ad. So there's more and more people interested in that. We now do things like, for example, there's a very well-known magazine in Germany that tells you about TV programs, and they have pictures of the movies that are on TV, and then you can put the smartphone against that and then plays then a trailer. So now you see the combination of print media and augmented reality digital information combined.
또 이제 쇼핑에서도 많은 이용이 되고 있는데 특히 이런 면에서 요구가 또 높아지고 있다고 합니다. 또 시각적으로 많은 것을 제공해 줄 수도 있는데요. 이렇게 자신의 정면 사진을 찍어서 티셔츠의 프린트에 갖다 대었을 때 자기의 그런 사진에 티셔츠가 입혀진다거나 하면서 그런 핸드폰을 이용한 쇼핑이 가능해지고 있고요. 또 이제 요새 또 각광받고 있는 것이 프린트와 이런 미디어 앱을 결합을 시키는 것인데요. 증강현실에서는 이게 가능하기 때문에 위에 잡지 표지에 보시면은 그 여자 모델이 얼굴을 가리고 있는데 이러한 앱을 이용을 해서 봤을 때 플레이를 하면은 이제 그런 손이 이렇게 치워지면서 얼굴이 보인다든지 하는 그런 인터랙션이 가능하게 됩니다. 그래서 또 거기에 이제 더해서 광고와의 결합도 가능해져서 많은 관심을 받고 있다고 합니다.
The next example is indoor navigation, which I've mentioned before. You saw also a bit of that in the film. This one here, this picture is from the Intel Developer Forum in San Francisco recently, where we built an indoor guide as well for that conference. And the last picture is from the Mobile World Congress. They created an ad, as you can see here on the floor, which was published in many magazines around the world. And then when you put your smartphone on it, it displays this rotating application globe.
인텔의 컨퍼런스에서도 많이 활용이 되는데요. 그런 전에 말씀드린 바와 같이 실내에서는 GPS가 이용이 가능하지 않는데 여기 이제 컨퍼런스가 하고 있을 때 그런 가이드로서 어디를 찾아가야 하는지와 같은 마커 같은 거를 위치를 시켜서 스마트폰을 놓았을 때 그런 위치를 용이하고 쉽게 찾을 수 있게 해줍니다. 또 이제 이러한 것을 또 3D 광고에도 활용을 해서 광고의 그런 지면에 핸드폰을 갖다 대었을 때 3D 광고가 뜨는 것으로도 활용되고 있습니다.
Right, here we have again the t-shirt application, so I don't have to say much about that. This is another interesting thing. People are now talking about virtual advertising, and this is one of the things that we have also pioneered. We're not the only ones, but we see a great future in this. How this works is, let's say, a tourist is traveling to Munich in this case, or to Seoul, and he's looking around what are the sites. So typically he can open in Juneau the Wikipedia channel, and it tells him about important sites to visit. And and then within that channel, we can inject some advertisement. In this case, this is a German parcel service. They have thousands of shops across the country. And these little ads here, you can see here on the right-hand side, Hermes, parcel shop. And then you click on it and you get more information on that. So this is how we can inject advertisements similar to Google AdSense. And then the channel owner can decide if he wants advertising or what kind of advertising, to make a context, relate to the context of the channel. So we expect great potential for this kind of commercialization.
네, 광고 설명이거나 설명인데요. 이런 식으로 광고를 삽입을 할 수 있는데, 주나요 같은 경우 예를 들면은 어딘가로 여행을 갔는데 그런 주나요를 통해서 위키페디아에 접속을 하면은 어떤 곳이 관광하기 좋다 이런 식의 정보가 뜨게 됩니다. 또 그 밑에 이제 추가적으로 뭐 파스 서비스에 뭐 체인 스토어가 있는데 뭐 이런 스토어에 이런 것을 제공하고 있다라는 광고가 밑에 같이 뜨는데 이제 그것을 선택해서 뭐 원한다면 갈 수도 있고 이제 그런 식으로 광고가 밑에 작게 뜨면서 선택을 해서 인포메이션을 좀 더 이제 쉽게 접근을 할 수 있겠습니다. 또 유저들이 이제 이 광고를 어떤 방식으로 볼 것인지에 대한 뷰를 선택을 할 수도 있고요. 또 이렇게 해서 또 새로운 그런 구글과는 또 다른 이제 방식으로 광고가 삽입이 되고 있기 때문에 새로운 가능성을 열어두고 있습니다.
The other opportunity to commercialize this is with micro transactions, for example, using paid channels. If you have particularly valuable information within a channel, then users may want to pay for it, maybe $1 one time or a month or whatever, if that is very valuable information, like in this case, the answer to the crossword puzzle. Or you could have a game. We have here this shooter game. It's an augmented reality game. So again, that can be offered maybe for some money. Now we have tablets. Tablets are now coming out, and they're becoming more and more powerful, and they are really fantastic machines for augmented reality because they're lightweight, mobile, you can take them anywhere. You have a large display, you have onboard cameras, often now dual cameras. There's GPS and other sensors on board also because augmented reality eats up a lot of computing power. So now we have dual processors, much more powerful machines than a little while ago, and they allow us to do many more interesting things with augmented reality.
이제 타블렛이 많이 대중화되기 시작하면서 이제 어떤 특별한 장치로서 작용이 되고 있습니다. 증강현실을 위한 어떤 최고의 기기라고도 볼 수 있는데요. 어떤 이제 무게도 굉장히 가벼워지고 있고 디스플레이도 매우 크며 카메라도 이제 거의 모든 타블렛에 탑재되어 있고 GPS와 다른 센서들도 가능하며 또한 이제 증강현실의 특성상 많은 그런 하드 파워를 잡아먹게 되는데 듀얼 프로세서까지 되어 있기 때문에 그 되게 증강현실을 활용할 수 있는 최고의 기기라고 보고 있습니다.
So, what is the future going to bring us? Basically, it depends on two things. One is more enabling technology. There is every month new announcement with new hardware, faster, better, more type of interesting equipment. And that's very good for augmented reality. The second one is content. In Juneau or other browsers like that, it's building up. It's still very much at the beginning, but we imagine within the next few years it will build up a lot of content. So people have these little machines can become really interesting instruments for getting information instantly, mobile. So it's like a very much augmented reality enhanced type of Google, if you want. That's why we call it augmented reality browsers. So they're all purpose software machines, really. And we believe this AR will become an standard interface technology and something that will become very natural for people to use every day. Here's a quick example, just, sorry, I you should, I forgot you. Mustn't forget you.
네. 네, 이제 그런 미래를 봤을 때 증강현실의 활용도에 관한 이야기인데요. 이제 계속해서 기술이 발전이 되고 있고 하드웨어도 점점 더 이제 좋게 그리고 점점 더 빠르게 개발이 되고 있습니다. 그래서 그러므로 인해서 이런 이렇게 해서 좀 더 이제 증강현실에 더 쉽게 다가설 수 있게 됐고 계속해서 컨텐츠 또한 증가하고 있기 때문에 그런 어떤 흥미 있고 지속적인 인포메이션을 접근을 할 수 있습니다. 또 이제 증강현실은 이제 이런 개발 과정을 같이 밟아가면서 좀 더 보편화될 수 있다고 보고 있습니다.
So just a quick example, you can see how technology is developing on the hardware side. This is a statistic showing frames per second. Now on film, you have 30 frames per second typically, and then you can see the different hardware. Like the HTC here at the bottom is only 5.8 frames per second. And now we have the LG Optimus latest model at 55 frames per second. So that gives a much richer picture, of course, and makes the AR experience also more impressive. Here is the kind of thing that I showed before with the printer maintenance. I think that we'll see much more of that for all sorts of equipment to show us how to use something. This can be used for educational purposes of all sorts of nature, for children or for adult training, you know, whatever you want. Here is an interesting thing. I'll show you a quick video on that. because this is a problem that we call occlusion. When you know, like you have the teapot here, this is a graphic image, and then when you move the hand behind, the hand should disappear. Now, this isn't so pretty yet, this example, because we're still experimenting with it. It's a prototype that's not finished, so within the next few months, we'll have a more smoother looking example of that. It's complicated to do, so this is a very advanced technology in AR as well. Oops, not yet. I think that was self-explanatory, right? Yeah. Okay, this is interesting. This is a new smartphone that will come soon in the market, the LG Optimus 3D. It has two cameras and they're stereo cameras. Now, that gives us entirely new possibilities because now we can, with the two cameras, we have a stereo vision, and the software can actually now calculate 3D space. So it works very easy. For example, if you have one camera looking at a particular object, you can measure the angle of that object from my base. And then looking at the second camera, you also measure the angle, and now you can triangulate the position of that object, and you know the distance from me to the object. And you can measure the object itself as well, you know, how large it is and how it relates to other objects in 3D space. Now, that means if we now have a 3D model, a graphic model, we can now place it in the right position within that 3D space and also show it in perspective in the right size so that when you go away from the object or you go nearer to the object, it will then become larger or smaller. And then we also can use that as another way of inputting information, which is what I want to show here, where we have this this little knight, and this is a 3D model, And now as you move closer with the finger, that can be sensed and it causes a reaction. You see it once more. There you go. Oops. So. Okay, so what is the world going to look like in a couple of years from now, 2 or 3 years from now? This is what we imagine, for example. You could take your mobile phone and scan the content of your fridge, and it knows the products, and it knows which products you usually have in your fridge, and it knows the absence. So it tells you, oh, we need milk. And so it can build a shopping list, you know, of the things that are missing from the fridge. When you go to the supermarket with indoor navigation, it can actually tell you where the milk can be found in the supermarket. And then when you hold, when you look at certain products, for example, maybe some cereal or some washing powder, it will tell you about that product because there may be a barcode in it, or it will recognize the picture on the product. And then look in the database via internet and tell you the ingredients of this product. Maybe if it's food, it could tell you a recipe that goes with it, or it tells you if it's environmentally safe, you know, and that kind of stuff. So it's interesting. We can also have fun for the kids when they eat their breakfast in the morning. They can look at the cereal with their smartphone and play a little game, computer-generated game. At work, you can get training with AR. I mentioned this before, or you can just, you know, give a virtual banana to a virtual pet that is sitting in your living room.
네, 이제 앞으로 증강현실이 좀 더 보편화되었을 때 미래를 되게 재미있게 상상을 해봤을 때 이야기인데요. 만약에 그런 냉장고 같은 곳에 핸드폰으로 스캔을 했을 때 아, 늘상 있던 뭐 우유가 없다고 하면은 우유를 사야 된다고 알려주고 그걸 이제 쇼핑을 이제 가가지고 우유들을 쫙 비췄을 때 어떤 우유가 뭐 좋고 나에게 적합하고 이러한 정보들이 다 뜨게 됩니다. 그리고 이제 매번 뭐 우유 이외에도 뭐 시리얼에 갖다 대었을 때 그런 프로덕트에 관한 설명이 다 뜨게 되어 있고 또 이제 뭐 아이들이 좋아하는 예를 들어 그런 시리얼 회사에서 게임을 제공을 한다 했을 때 시리얼에 딱 핸드폰을 갖다 댔을 때 게임이 실행돼서 게임도 할 수 있는 그런 미래를 상상을 합니다. 또 이제 그거 외에도 뭐 가상 펫 같은 거를 그 부엌 같은 데 비췄을 때 부엌에서 막 돌아다니고 있다든지 그렇게 해서 뭐 가상 바나나도 주고 약간 그런 재미있는 상상을 해볼 수 있습니다.
The possibility of identifying products, by the way, this is if you're trying out Janaya right now, it's not in there yet. We're working on it right now. It will come within the next 2 to 3 months. We'll work with different ways of recognizing product. Could be a QR code or a barcode or even a picture. So that will be added soon. Okay, this is the end of my presentation. I have a final video still. I just want to draw your attention to this. I don't know if anybody plans to travel to Europe in September. We have a conference of 2 days where we show everything that's new in augmented reality and have speakers from around the world presenting their projects, both customers as well as partners. So, as I said, that's the end of my presentation and I will now give you the last video. This is on tablets. This is our little show reel, what we do with tablet computers. So you have a look at our office. This is a lovely colleague from Guatemala. She works in Munich at the moment and she's going back to the States now. So here is another application. We can give you user instruction how to attach a device here, for example, similar to the printer case. Here we have a colleague who wants to buy new hubcaps for his car, and then he could look at a tablet here, for example, try out different hubcaps and see which ones he likes best on his car. Here is a little fun. You have a football game and somebody's kicking the ball and it ends up in your living room. Here, this friend of mine, he is buying garden furniture and he wants to try it out in his garden, see what it looks like. So you see, again, this is... Here we have shopping, so we're trying out different watches, different colors maybe. And here we have another bit of fun. This is Willem Tell. You know, you probably, William Tell, you shoot the apple from his head. So, bingo. Okay, that's it from me. Thank you very much for listening. And I hope it gave you new insights.